Good morning, students. In our earlier class, we studied the different types of sliding contact bearings based upon the different types of load it can support, as well as the nature of contact it can support, as well as the based on the construction. So apart of that, in this class, so we are going to see what is the lubrication and why the lubrication is very much essential in the sliding contact bearings, as well as whatever the bearings it is. So what are the different types of lubrications we are going to use for the bearings. First, coming to the lubrication. So why the lubrication is essential? So in sliding contact bearings, we know that the classification can be done based upon the nature of contact between the two surfaces. Clear? So here in the sliding contact bearings means the bearing surface, the surface which can slides upon the surface of the another surface, that is what the sliding nature is. So here the bearing surface is a fixed surface, that is a fixed element we consider as, and the second moving element, that is a machine component, is a sliding contact, that is a moving machine element which slides upon the surface of the bearing surface, that is in this fashion. If it is an for example, you can take this is a fixed member. So this fixed member is considered as a bearing surface, and this one as a movable machine component, which is a machine moving surface. So whenever this machine surface is tends to move upon this surface, so there will always a sliding nature of the sliding contact will be present in between the two surfaces. So here the machine surface, the moving machine element as well as the fixed element, both are the metals. So whenever there is a metal to metal contact will be there, so there is always a generation of friction. So as we already know that, that is a friction may generate between the two surfaces. Due to the friction, so these moving element can rotate with higher speeds, so there is a chance of heat generation. So due to this heat generation, or as well as to overcome the friction, so the power is going to be wasted between the two surfaces, so that the power is lost in the friction, so that the total power cannot be taken for the utilization of our purpose. So there is always a reduction in power to overcome the friction between the two surfaces. So that to avoid or to reduce the power, that is a reduction, or the power that is going to consume in the friction, we are going to use a lubricant between the two surfaces. So with some viscous oil, we are going to introduce between the two surfaces, that we call it as a lubricant. Whenever we can apply between the two surfaces, that lubricant can provide a smooth movement of the two relative motion elements, that is a fix between the fixed element and the movable element, that allows the smooth displacement between the, that is a smooth sliding fashion between the two surfaces, which reduces the friction. And these process we call it as a lubrication. So the main function of these lubrication, so here it is application of the suitable oil, that we call it as between the two rubbing surfaces, that is what called a lubrication. So the main objective of the lubrication is it is used to reduce a friction between the two surfaces, so as well as it can prevent wear. So whenever the two machine components will be in contact, there is a friction, it is okay, but if one of the component is moving with high speed, so there is a chance of wear. So due to this wear, there is a deformation, that is that assembly can affect the transmission of power, so that by means of the application of the lubricant, we can also reduce the wear or to prevent wear between the two surfaces, as well as we can also use it to take away the heat as the friction is generated, so that it can allows to generate heat. So again, there is a power loss will be there. So whatever the heat generated between these two surfaces, that is machine surface and the bearing surface, that heat can be taken away by means of these lubricant, what you are providing between the two surfaces. That is to carry away the heat which we generated between the surfaces, as well as it can also use it to prevent corrosion. So these are the main objectives of the lubricant or the lubrication. sorry, lubrication between the two surfaces that we are going to provide for these much of needs. So we need a lubrication process is very much essential in the bearings between the two mating parts. Clear? So in these sliding contact bearings, these lubrication can be classified, that is, we can have a different types of modes we can observe in the sliding contact bearings, that we call it as an modes of lubrication. So in modes of lubrication, so the first type of mode is a thick film lubrication. So here are the journal bearings, as I said that the journal bearings is a plain bearings which can support a radial type of loads, that bearings we call it as a journal bearings. So here the journal bearings can also be classified based upon the type of lubrication mode that bearings can also be classified. So for example, we are having a thick film lubrication, and the bearings which can operate using the thick film lubrication, we call it as thick film bearings. Clear? So that is what we call it as a thick film bearing. So now coming to the, what is thick film? So in the name itself, we can observe. So as I stated that, so there is a two surface, there are always a two surfaces. So we need to provide a lubricant between the two surfaces. Clear? So I can illustrate using this example. So you can observe what, so this is one of the surface, that is this is one surface and this one is another surface. So here if you observe clearly the surface, the contact between the two surfaces is completely separated by means of the lubricant that between these two surfaces. So this represents the thickness of the oil, that is a lubricant. So here the two surfaces, the surface of the bearing as well as the surface of the machine component is completely separated by means of a layer of, that is a, that layer having enough thickness to separate these two machine surfaces. That type of lubrication is called thick film lubrication, and the bearings that can operate under these type of lubrication mode, we call it as thick film bearings. Clear? So here can observe clearly. So this one is the one of the machine surface and this one is the bearing surface. So here the oil is provided, that is the lubricant oil is provided between the two surfaces. So there is no direct metal to metal contact. So whatever the point you can take, there is no direct contact between the two machine surfaces. So these two surfaces can completely separated by means of a thick layer of lubricant, so that there is no direct metal to metal contact. So whenever there is no direct metal to metal contact, there is no metal friction is present in these type of lubricated bearings. Clear? In thick film bearings, there is no metal friction. But we don't say that there is no friction. So it is absence of metal friction, but there is always a presence of viscous friction. So here, for due to the viscosity of the lubricant, you studied the properties of the lubricant in FMHM. So the fluid lubricant can have the viscosity. Due to the viscosity of the lubricant, that affects the friction. That friction we call it as a viscous friction. So here there is no metal friction is present in these type of bearings, but there is a viscous friction is present. So that type of bearings we call it as thick film bearings. So here for providing these kind of lubrication, that is for forming the thick film between the two surfaces, there is a two methods of methods we are going to follow. So one of the method is a hydrodynamic lubrication. So for forming the thick film, there is a two methods to obtain the thick film between the two surfaces. One is a hydrodynamic type and another one is hydrostatic type. That we can discuss in the coming class. Clear? So and coming to the next type of or the next mode of lubrication, that is a thin film lubrication. So as I stated that in the previous case, that is a thick film. So there is no any direct metal to metal contact. So it, the surfaces are completely separated by means of a thick layer of lubricant, that is called thick film. But coming to the thin film, in the name itself, so there is a presence of lubricant will be there, but the thickness of the lubricant or the thickness of lubricating oil is, does not sustain for a long while, so to separate the two metal components. So again you can observe in this diagram, so there is a presence of lubricant. So this is again, this is the surface of the metal surface and this is the surface of the bearing, that is one is the bearing machine component, and another one is a, that is a machine, whatever the relative motion we have. So that is the another component. So you can observe these two are surfaces are completely separated, that is separated by means of a layer of lubricant. So layer of lubricant is present here, but in some of the cases, so for example, you can take up to this extent. So this there is no direct metal to metal contact, but coming to particularly at this particular juncture, so the layer of lubricant is going to break. So it does not sustain at this moment due to the force or the pressure acting on the or the load acting on the another machine component here. So that this thin layer of lubricant is going to break. That breakdowns will going to give the contact between the machine component surface as well as the bearing surface. Clear? So as well as you can also observe, again there is no contact between these. So and here you can observe there is a contact. So this kind of where lubrication method, we call it as a thin film lubrication, and the bearings which can operate under these kind of lubrication is called the bearings is called thin film bearings. Clear? So in this kind there is a presence of lubricant is there. So the lubricant is present, but there is a partial metal to metal contact will be there between the two surfaces, bearing as well as a machine surface. Clear? The layer of lubricant is present, but there is a partial metal to metal contact. In the previous case, there is a complete separation will be present. That is, complete separation can be formed. But in this case, the layer of lubricant is present, even though it is a presence of lubricant, but there is a chance of a partial metal to metal contact between the two surfaces. This kind of lubrication, we call it as a thin film lubrication, and the bearings that operate under using or using these kind of lubrication mode, we call it as thin film bearings. So here in this case, you can observe there is a chance of metal to metal contact. So whenever there is a direct metal to metal contact will be there is always a metal friction. So here in this case, the metal friction will be there as well as the friction, viscous friction will also be present. So coming to, okay, that is comparing with the thick film. So the friction, the amount of friction that possible in this case is very much greater, that is relatively greater compared to the thick film bearings. Clear? So that is what thick film and thin film. So in thick film, it is completely separated by means of layer of lubricant, but in the thin film, so it can be partially in contact between the two surfaces, even though the presence of lubricant between the two components. And the third mode of lubrication is zero film lubrication. So here in the zero film, you can observe the name. So zero film lubrication, the bearings which can operate using the zero film type of lubrication, now we call it as zero film bearings. So in the name itself stating that zero film, so that is, which means the film that present between the two surfaces is completely zero. So there is no layer of lubricant is present between the two metal surfaces. So in the previous case, you can observe the layer of lubricant, but one case it is a thick, and another case it is thin. But coming to the third case, there is no layer of lubricant is present between the two surfaces. There is always a direct metal to metal contact will be there. So there is only a clearance will be provided between the two surfaces, but there is no lubricant is present between the two surfaces. That type of lubrication we call it as zero film. So generally, so that so for the lubricating oils, you can use a mineral oils or synthetic oils, and for the zero film lubrication, they can use the carbon or graphite. So and later on, they are also evolving the different bearing materials to reduce the friction as well as the wear conditions. A lot of research is going on for these kind of lubricant without having the providing the layer proper lubricant between the two surfaces, so you can obtain the friction as well as the wear. That is going to find out during the research conditions. So there is no lubricant is present, so that resulting in obviously the high amount of friction between the two surfaces. Clear? These are the three types of three modes of lubrication modes, and the bearings you can also classify based upon that. So if it is an operating using the thick film bearings, that is a thick film, so we call it as a thick film bearings. And if it can operate using the thin film, we call it as a thin film bearings. And the bearings that can operate using the zero film called as zero film bearings. And as I said that in the thick film bearings, so in order to form the thick film, so there are the two methods we are having. That is the types, so we call it as a hydrodynamic type, and another one is hydrostatic type. And first of all, you can go into the hydrostatic, that is sorry, hydrodynamic type. So in these hydrodynamic lubricated bearings, we need to take some assumptions. So the lubricant that we are going to provide between the two surfaces, that lubricant must obey the Newton's law of viscosity, that is a viscous film, and then the viscosity as well as the pressure should be constant throughout the oil thickness, and there is a supply of oil should be continuous and there is no side leakage. There are some of the assumptions we need to take it out. So that one, the first one is it should obey the Newton's law of viscous flow, as well as it should, the flow should be, the pressure is assumed to be constant throughout the pressure film thickness, and it is also assumed to be incompressible flow, so that is the force can, it can withstand, as well as the viscosity can also be constant throughout the film thickness, and then there is no side leakage. So these are the main assumptions we can consider. Apart of that, you can also consider some of the factors, that is continuous oil supply will be there, so that if there is an oil leakage will be there. So we are already assumed that there is no oil leakage, even though we can consider the factor that there is a continuous supply of oil will be there, and then we can, there is a relative motion which should be approximately tangential to the surfaces. If there is a two surfaces, so they are having the ability to make an angle. So while rotating the shaft, that is a journal inside the bearing surface, there should be a tangential in motion, that is a tangential in direction approximately, as well as it can assume to take up the inclination to the other surface with respect to the relative motion. And then finally, the line of action or the resultant should be pressure between the external load or the line of action, that is oil pressure result, oil pressure, the force of oil pressure should be taken equal to the line of action of the bearing. Clear? So this is the main factors that you can consider for the hydrodynamic type of bearings. So now coming to the process of hydrodynamic lubricated bearings, so can observe three conditions of the shafts here. So for the first shaft, that is the first diagram indicates, so the, if you observe clearly the diagram, so the outer circle represents a bearing surface, and the inner circle that represents, that is journal surface, that is called as shaft. So as I said that the shaft which can lie under the that bearing, we call it as a journal. So here I stated with the shaft. So the inner circle is a shaft and the outer circle is a bearing. So here the pink color that indicates the clearance between the two surfaces, and that can be filled with a lubricating oil. Clear? So this is at the condition of rest. So the load, the both the axes, you can observe clearly the both the axes are aligned, or the exactly aligned in the same axis. The both the centers are exactly at the same axis line, and the force is acting downwards. So by the application of the force F on the journal, so there is always the force will be acting, so that the journal tends to be in contact with the bearing surface at this particular area. So there is no contact between these surfaces. So we know that the diameter of the journal is smaller compared to the diameter of the bearing. So in order to provide a clearance between the two surfaces, so that there is a clearance, it can be filled with lubricant. So here, whenever the load is applied on the shaft, that is a journal, the shaft may, the journal may tends to in contact directly here, so that direct metal to metal contact will be present. There is no layer of lubricant will be provided between the two surfaces here. So due to the application of load, so the surface of the journal is directly in contact with the surface of the bearing. So there is a very high amount of friction is present at the condition of rest position. Clear? So that is at the rest condition. So and next coming to the, so you are going to start the engine, or you are going to start the machine. So the shaft can start rotating slowly. So in the initial stage of rotation, so that can, the shaft can tends to rotate. So in the factors, we stated that it can ability. So one of the factor we have considered that it has the ability to take up an inclination with respect to the axis of the bearing. So that whenever the journal tends to rotate at a slow speed condition, so this is at slow speed conditions. So at the slow speed conditions, the shaft can take an inclination, that is the axis, you can observe there is a taken some inclination with respect to the here, the both the centers of the shaft as well as the bearing are aligned, that is coincides, but in here they may taken some inclination with respect to the axis of the bearing. So apart of that, the bearing, that is a journal, can also be tends to take a shift, that is which causes some eccentricity between the two surfaces, even though there is a presence of a layer of lubricant, but there is a partial metal to metal contact. So here there is direct metal to metal contact, the friction amount is very much high, and coming to the slow speed conditions, even though it can forms the layer of lubricant, but the layer of lubricant is thin film, so it does not sustain by the application of the load F. It is going to be in contact, the layer of lubricant is going to break. The pressure that is acting on the journal is it is very much greater than the pressure build up in the lubricant that is present in between the surfaces, so that the layer of lubricant is going to break. So that resulting in the direct metal to metal contact, again the friction will be generated. So here in the slow speed conditions, so again the possibility of friction. So compared to the rest condition, the friction is less, even though it is very much greater friction will be generated here. That is a thin film condition, the bearing is operating at slow speed conditions. Clear? So that is a thin film, that the lubrication condition called as boundary layer lubrication. So even though there is a presence of lubrication, but partial metal to metal contact will be present between the two surfaces. And coming to the high speed condition, so even though, so the speed is going to increase gradually from N to some N1, so it is going to increase, so again the shaft speed is going to increase us, so that so the shaft can take some this inclination of the axis can form an so for example you can take this particular junction, so we can observe by the rotation of the journal which will form some converging channel between the surfaces, so from A to B you can observe clearly, so this is the area you can observe from here to here onwards which will form some converging area, so I can separately indicate here, so the in this case, so it will be like in this fashion. So in this fashion, clear, I can enlarge it here, so it can be having the convergent zone. So at the with the increasing of speed due to the inclination, that ability of axis of shaft, it can take inclination with respect to the bearing axis, so that which forms a convergent zone. So here during this convergent zone, by the rotation of the shaft, the journal, the lubricant, the lubricant can also be in contact, that is so here the layer of lubricant should be in contact with the surface of the bearing. So whenever the journal is rotating, the layer that is in contact with the bearing can also be tends to take rotate, that is going to rotate along with the rotation of the shaft, in the direction of the rotation of shaft, so that so gradually the layer of lubricant, all the layer of lubricants can also tends to rotate along with the direction of the shaft, so that the layer of all the fluid that present between the surfaces can also tends to move along with the direction of the journal, so that by the rotation of the or the flow of the fluid, so here we can observe clearly it is a convergent channel it provides. So whenever the fluid that passes through the convergent zone, so we know that it acts as a nozzle from greater cross section area to the smaller cross section area, so that convergent channel that provides between the two surfaces acts as a nozzle. So whenever the fluid that passes through the nozzle, that is going to increase the pressure. So whenever the fluid can pass through this convergent zone, so after that so here that builds a pressure, so after that it can easily flow to the again convergent zone from B to A. So that the fluid, whenever it passes, the fluid pressure is very much greater. So here the this is the amount of pressure build up in the fluid by the passage through the convergent zone. So that gives rise to the pressure build up in the zone. So whatever the pressure that build up in this area or in this zone, so here this amount of pressure, that pressure is very much enough to levitate the shaft inside the bearing. Clear? So that so the shaft is going to tends to levitate so that it forms a thick layer of lubricant between the two surfaces. So that is what we call as this is at the normal speeds. So here you can observe the three conditions. So initially, so when the shaft is at rest condition, so there is a direct metal to metal contact, the high friction will be there. And the second condition, that is at slow speed conditions, so even there is a presence of layer of lubricant, but so these force, whatever the force acting upon the shaft, it is going to break that thin layer, there is a partial metal to metal contact, and that obtained at the slow speed conditions, so that there is a metal to metal friction is present, but it is comparatively low amount of friction. Clear? And the type of lubrication we call it as boundary layer lubrication. And coming to the another case, so that is the same shaft is going to increase the speed, so which creates a convergent zone. So whenever the fluid passes through the convergent zone, that increases the fluid pressure between the two surfaces. So that pressure, whatever the pressure build up in the fluid, that is lubricating oil, is enough to levitate the shaft inside the bearing surface, that is a bearing clearance. So that the shaft is going to levitate along with the load, that is F, supported load acting on the shaft. So this is the pressure build up on the between the bearing. So this pressure is enough to support this shaft along with the load F. So that that can form a thick layer of lubricant between the two surfaces. Clear? So don't confuse with the three diagrams. So all the three diagrams are same. So one is at rest condition, and initially you are going to start, and it rotates at slow speed conditions, operate at boundary layer lubrication, that is thin film, and the final when it operates with the normal speed, we can obtain a thick film. So this is called we call it as hydrodynamic lubrication, and the bearings that operate using these kind of phenomenon we call it as hydrodynamic lubricated bearings. So in majority of the cases, 90% of the bearings, you can observe all the bearings are operating using this hydrodynamic type of lubrication. So in the name itself, hydrodynamic, the layer of lubricant can be obtained by means of dynamic motion of the journal. So we don't obtain a thick film initially, but the thick film can be obtained by the, how it is going to form? So by the rotation of the journal. Whenever the journal can rotate, then only the thick film of lubricant can be obtained between the surfaces, so that it is in motion we are going to obtain the thick film, not at the static condition. So here these kind of lubrication film, that is a wedging action. So it is a lubricated journal bearing, uses a fluid, and this pressure is required is to support journal generally by means of wedging action, that is a wedge form. So this is what converging zone, that is called wedge action. So whenever the fluid passes through this convergent zone, that is a wedging action can take place, that increases the pressure inside the bearing surface. Clear? 90% of the bearings what you are observed generally are simple hydrodynamic type of lubrication. So here there is another type of lubricated bearing, that is a hydrostatic. Initially, at the initial stage of the bearing only, you can obtain thick film. That is how you are going to obtain a thick film in a hydrostatic lubricated bearings, that we will discuss in next class. Clear? Thank you. So, okay, you can see here, we are having a simple example, that is how the thick film of lubricant can be present in the bearings. So, you can observe using this animation. So here the surface, this is the bearing shaft, that is a journal. So and this is this circle represents a bearing surface. So there is always a clearance will be there in between. So here it is a journal and the bearing. So in between the clearance, the lubricant can be present. So we can observe clearly here. So that the shaft, so here it is so the square portion of portion, it can represent the shaft or journal. So can see using these animations. So this is the portion that is indicates bearing, and in between that we can provide a lubricated oil between the two surfaces. So as I stated that this is the hydrodynamic bearing. So the film can be obtained by its own due to the dynamic action of rotation of the shaft. So don't provide any additional forces or additional external means. We don't obtain the hydrodynamic lubrication, but we can obtain by the rotation. So this is the initial stage. So the shaft, you can observe the shaft is going to be in contact with the bearing surface. So whenever the shaft is going to rotate, so here I can observe it is at rest condition. So both are having a direct metal to metal contact, so that there is no layer of lubricant present between the two surfaces. So that whenever the bearing, that is a journal is tends to rotate slowly. So you can observe clearly. So this is at a slow speed condition. So whenever the slow speed condition, the journal rotates, it can go into moves or slides upon the surface of the bearing, so that it can form the thin layer. So not a completely thick film, but it can form a thin layer of lubricant between the two surfaces, the shaft and bearing. So later on, when the shaft tends to increase the speed of the journal, so that the layer of lubricant that forms between the surfaces may also be going to increase due to the pressure buildup inside the shaft, so that the shaft is going to levitate and come into the center of the bearing surface. Clear? So that is what how the hydrothick film layer of lubricant can be obtained in the bearing. So in the next class we can see the how the hydrostatic bearing can be how the thick layer of lubricant can be observed in the hydrostatic type of bearings, and what are the different terms used in the hydrostatic bearing. As per our syllabus point of view, we are going to restrict to the hydrostatic dynamic lubricated bearings, not with the hydrostatic. So we can surely mention that is we need to see how the hydrodynamic is most important than the hydrostatic, because of as per our subject point of view, we need to know how the thick layer of lubricant can be present in the hydrodynamic type of lubrication. Clear? So in the next class we can discuss how the thick film can be obtained in the so lubrication is very much essential in the bearing surfaces. So there is a direct metal to metal contact, so that we need to introduce lubricant between the two surfaces, so that it can helps to reduce friction as well as wear, and in some of the cases it can also avoid corrosion between the two surfaces. And then the lubricant whatever presenting that is introducing between the surfaces can also helps to take away the heat between the surfaces developed by means of the friction. So and can also discuss what are the different types of lubrications, that is the modes of lubrication. We are having the three modes. So one is a thick film, and another one is thin film, and the third one is zero film. So in the thick film, so the two surfaces are completely separated by means of a thick layer of lubricant. So there is no metal friction, so that there is no direct metal to metal contact, no metal friction. And coming to the thin film lubrication, so even though there is a presence of lubricant, but it can there is a presence of partial metal to metal contact is present. So in this case, the layer of lubricant is completely separated by the, that is two surfaces are completely separated by the lubricant, and here the bearing surface is partially separated by means of lubricant. And coming to the zero film, and there is no any lubricant is present between the two surfaces. Okay, so in these two cases, so there is a presence of lubricant, and in the thick film there is no direct metal to metal contact, completely separated by the lubricant. But in this thin film, even though there is a presence of lubricant, there is a partial metal to metal contact will be there. So in this case there is no metal friction, and in this case the metal friction will be present, and here in this case we are having a greater metal friction. So in the thick film there is only a viscous friction will be there, there is no metal friction. Clear? And again in the thick film lubrication, in order to obtain a thick film, so we are having the two different systems we need to incorporate to obtain the thick film. So that is hydrodynamic type, hydrodynamic, and another one is hydrostatic type. We discussed about these hydrodynamic. So in this hydrodynamic, the thick film can be obtained due to its self-movement of the, that is a rotating of the journal by means of a wedging action between the bearing surface and then the journal surface. So due to that, the thick film can be obtained in the hydrodynamic lubrication. But in the case of hydrostatic, that you have not discussed in this class, in the later class we are going to discuss, along with we are going to discuss. But in this hydrodynamic lubrication bearings, we can see in the what are the various assumptions and what are the various different factors and how the thick film is going to, that is form by means of rotation of the shaft, we discussed in this class. In the earlier next class, we are going to see, so what is hydrostatic bearings, how the thick film is going to obtain in the hydrostatic bearings, as well as the terms used in the hydrodynamic bearings. As per our syllabus point of view, the hydrodynamic bearings are essential, that is you need to understand what are the terms. So based upon these terms, the same terms can be used in design criteria also, that is which is very much important. So that next class we are going to see the hydrostatic bearings and terms used in hydrostatic bearings.